that place. We are taking our text from Genesis Genesis 39. I will just read verses 2-9 and verse 21. Verses 2-9 and verse 21 of Genesis chapter 39. And Joseph was brought down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an official of Pharaoh, captain of the guard of Egyptian, bought him of the hands of the Ishmaelites, which had brought him down. And the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of his master the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made of him all that he did to prosper in his hand. And Joseph found grace in the sight, and his wife will serve him. And he made him overseer over his house. And all that he had, he put into his hand. And he came to pass from the time that he had made him overseer in his house, and over all that he had, that the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. And the blessing of the Lord was upon all that he had in the house and in the field. And he left all that he had in Joseph's hand, and he knew not aught he had, save the bread which he did eat. And Joseph was a goodly person and well favored. And it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast her eyes upon Joseph, and she said, "Lie with me." But he refused and said unto his master's wife, "Behold, my master wrotheth not what is with me in the house, and he had committed all that he had to my hand. There is no greater in this house than I. Neither had he kept back anything from me but thee, because thou art his wife. How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God?" 21. But the Lord was with him, was with Joseph, and showed him mercy, and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. May God give us favor in the sight of our enemies, in the sight of the people around us. In Jesus' name. Amen. The topic says the importance of God's presence. The importance of God's presence. We are talking about the importance of God's presence. We are still looking again to Exodus 33. Exodus 33. Exodus 33, verses 13 to 15. Now, therefore, I pray thee, if I find grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation is thy people. And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. 15. And he said unto him, if thy presence go not with me, carry us not up hence. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in Jesus' name. Amen. I want us to understand something from this place. From the verse that we have read, and from the verses that we have read today, we are talking about the importance of God's presence. The presence of God is the determining factor to every believer's success, to every believer's victory, to every believer's achievement in life, to every believer on unusual exploits, on every believer's greatness in life. It is determined by the presence of God. Anybody that want to become great, want to succeed in life, the presence of God determines that. In other words, without the presence of God, believers or servants of God are bound to fail, are bound to become a failure without God's presence. Many men of old that succeeded in whatever thing they do is because the presence of God was put into consideration. The presence of God was noted. The presence of God was visible in their lives. And that's the reason why they could succeed. I pray we will not miss God's presence in the name of Jesus. David said in one of these, no wonder David said in Psalm 51 verse 11, cast me not away from thy presence, O Lord. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. This was the time that he committed sin, that we can say that he backslided. He committed sin, and the sin was grievous before the Lord. What he was looking and asking God for, Lord, cast me not away. Lord, out of your mercy, cast me not away from your presence. Do not take your spirit away from me. You know, David was moving with God in the power of the Holy Ghost. That's the reason why anytime he went out to fight the battle, the Spirit of the Lord will fall upon him and say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. With the Spirit of the Lord, he was able to achieve whatever he wanted. May the Spirit of the Lord not leave us. When the Spirit of the Lord leaves a man becomes an ordinary person. You become ordinary. When you become ordinary, there's nothing to support your life. You are just like a soldier without a gun. You are just like a soldier with your uniform, but you have no gun. No ammunition to defend yourself. What makes soldiers to become soldiers is because of the power that they have to protect themselves and protect the people around them. And that is how it is. Without the presence of God in our lives, there's no way we can achieve anything. From the text, from the second text that we read in Exodus chapter 33, 15 to 16, chapter 15, Moses did not ask for signs and wonders. Moses did not ask for miracles. Moses did not ask for greatness here. I want to become great. But Moses was asking because he knew that all these things are found in what Moses was about to ask God now. He didn't ask God all these things, but what did he ask God? He said, if I find grace in thy sight, show me now thy way. Show me now thy way. And God knew that the way or his way is found in his presence. His ways are found in his presence. And that is the reason why God answered. God answered. Because he said, let me find Eve. I know that I may know thy way. That I may know thy way. That I may find grace in thy sight. And consider that this nation is thy people. What did God answer? And the Lord God answered him. What did he say? And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. God knew that what Moses was asking God for was his way to show him his way. He knew that his way was in his presence. I will show. You know, at times when we are asking God something and we don't put it right, the Holy Spirit will help us to put it right because we do not know how to pray. We do not know how to pray, how to ask. That's the reason why the Bible says we don't know what to pray for. We don't know how to pray. But the Holy Spirit help our families. God said, it is my presence that you need. My presence will go with thee, and I will give you rest. Because he knew when his presence was with Moses, every task must be accomplished. The presence of God in your life will accomplish every task in the name of Jesus. And that's the reason why Moses was very happy. And he said, if thy presence will not go with me, I will not go. If your presence will not go with me, Moses now, he was now saying, if the presence of the Lord will not go with him, he will not go further. Praise the Lord. Because now he has known what the presence of God is all about. If your presence will not go with me, I will not go further. The presence of the Lord is very, very important. The presence of the Lord is very important. Miracle is found in His presence. Favor is found in His presence. Wonders, signs and wonders are found in His presence. And that's the reason why what we need to ask God for is His presence. When His presence is with you, every other thing will be accomplished. That's the reason why the Lord says that God was with them, confirming His word with signs following. God was with them, confirming His word with signs following. When the presence of God is with you, signs will be there, wonders will come, miracles will come, favor will come, grace will come, many other things that we need to the presence of God. And this presence of God is very, very important. We are going to consider some points, few points, as we look at this message, at the life of some servants of God in the Bible. We consider one, God's presence brings prosperity. God's presence will make you to prosper. God's presence attracts favor through grace. It attracts favor. God's presence commands holy living. When you have the presence of God with you, you will live a holy life. You will live a sanctified life. God's presence makes us fulfill our divine destiny and gives divine safety. God's presence makes us fulfill our divine destiny and gives all divine safety. May God help us in Jesus' name. God's presence brings prosperity. Prosperity. God's presence brings prosperity. You want to prosper in every area of life, it is the presence of God. You want to prosper secularly, to prosper spiritually, to prosper and become rich and become great and be what God wants you to become, the presence of God quickens that. Now, we can see the life of Joseph. The life of Joseph is a life of testimony, is a life that you must consider, we must look at and understand some things. The life of Joseph. Joseph was despised. He was hated. He was denied of his earthly inheritance, of his family inheritance, that he would never share with his father's inheritance forever. His brothers sold him to slavery. They hated him, sold him to slavery. that he would never amount to anything in life. All his dream that he had dreamed, let it fall upon him. None of them will come to pass. Let us see how it's going to become great. When he will not share with us our father's inheritance, let us see how it's going to become great. They sold him to slavery. But one day, the Lord God Almighty, his presence went along with him. May his presence follow you wherever you go. I say, may his presence follow you wherever you go in Jesus' name. The presence of the Lord was not taken away from him. The presence of the Lord was with him, went with him, and they have sold him. Even as he went into slavery, God was with him. Even his master's house, where they sold him to, God was directing him. The presence of the Lord that was with him made him to fall into a right hand. May God make you to fall into a right hand in Jesus' name. To fall into a right situation, a right position in life in Jesus' name. When you fall into a right position in life, you must be fulfilled in life. If you are in the right position. The presence of the Lord directed him to fall into the hands of somebody through whom he will become great in life. If the presence of the Lord was not with Joseph, Joseph wouldn't have fallen to the hands of Potiphar. Maybe it would have fallen to the hands of someone that would make him a slave. And they will maltreat him. And they will destroy his destiny. He will never come to the place where he was. Maybe he wouldn't have had a contact with somebody that would have been eyeing him, whether it's beautiful, whether it's handsome. And nothing would have made him to go to prison. Nothing would have made him to come in contact with Pharaoh. But the Lord directed him. The Lord was with him. May God order your steps. That is why the Bible says, the steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. You are a righteous person, the Lord will order your step. He ordered the steps of Joseph. Joseph fell into the right way, into the right hand. His life. He fell into the hands of Potiphar. I was in Potiphar's house. What happened here? Verses 2 and 3. And the Lord was with him, what with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man. And he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all things, all that he did, to prosper in his hand. Can you see? The Lord was with him. It was very evident, very vivid, very glaring that the Lord was with him. When the Lord is with you, is walking with you, nobody will tell you before you know. Even his master knew that God was with Joseph, that Joseph was not an ordinary child or ordinary slave. He didn't just buy ordinary slave. He got somebody whose spirit of the Almighty God, the spirit of the Most High, is with him. When the spirit of the Almighty God is with you, you are not an ordinary person. May me ordinate you. In the community, you may be adorated. In the family, you may not be matter to something, somebody. You may be matter to nothing. But when the Lord is with you, you are greater than them all. The people they saw that Joseph was not an ordinary person. All that he committed into his hand prosper. In the house of Potiphar, everything prosper. Praise the Lord. Do you know that when you are a righteous person, you are a righteous person, you are a believer, and you know that you are a believer indeed, not a fake believer. You are a true believer. Do you know that anywhere you go and work, anywhere you get employment, the presence of God will go with you there and be working with you there, and there will be a difference in that company. There will be a difference in that place because of your presence. By the time you leave that place, they will know that God came here and God went out. They will know. Because being a carrier of God into that place, everything that you do must prosper in that place. They saw it. That everything that Joseph did prosper. This will make him to be feared. He was more respected. He was more favored. May God help us in Jesus' name. Looking at the life of Joseph, of Isaac. Isaac was in the land of Gerar. At the land of Gerar, the land was not productive. The land seemed to be barren. It was not yielding high production. Things were so difficult and so tight in that place. The people of the land found it difficult to get the proper harvest. But Isaac was there that year. That same year. And the Bible says that same year that is so. That same year that is so. And he lived 100-fold. Praise the Lord. Because of the presence of the Lord with Isaac, the land that was not yielding anything became fruitful. That Lord will make the place where you are fruitful because of you. That Lord will make the place where you are dwelling to become productive because of you. That Lord will make it fertile because of you. In the name of Jesus. Because of Isaac, the land of Gerar became fruitful. A barren land became productive. It was so much that the nothing will not be accomplished for you. Nothing will not be accomplished for you with the presence of God with you. Nothing. Nothing will be made impossible. That's the reason why, if the presence of God with you, you are more than another person. You are more than another thing. You are more than majority. You are more than that. Can you see? Let us see 26. Genesis 26. I read from verses 12 to 14. 12 to 14. And then 16 to 17. And then Isaac sowed in that land that was barren, that was not yielding anything, that was not productive, that land, and he received in the same year 100-fold. And the Lord blessed him. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless whatever thing that you lay your hand upon. May the Lord prosper it. The Lord prosper it. The Lord bless it. And the man was great. Why? He was great because the Lord was with him. Everything that he accomplished was not him. The Lord divinely accomplished it for him. The hosts of heaven are working with him. The Spirit of the Lord, the Spirit of excellence, was working with him. He was directing him. God was doing it. He became great, was great, and went forward and grew until he became very great. The Lord will make somebody great here. Those that are hearing this message, the Lord will make you great. And you go further and become great in Jesus' name. For he had possession of flocks. Can you see? The Lord multiplied all his flocks in a high frequency of production. The Lord increased. And possession of herds and great store of servants, and the Philistines envied him. Can you see? Because of the way God blessed him, the Philistines there envy him. Do you know that when the Lord is blessing you, because of the presence of the Lord with you, the people around you will become envious of you. They'll be envying you. But whether they envy you or they cannot do you anything. Because whosoever will touch you, is touching God's eye. Because you are the apple of the Lord, the apple of God's eye. Nobody can touch you. You are declared untouchable. They were just envying him for nothing. They were envying him for nothing. What did they say? When they were envying him, and there is nothing they can do, they say, in verse 16 and 17, you see, and Abimelech said unto Isaac, go from us, for thou art much mightier than we. Do you see? Go away. They were envying him, that envious, cannot do anything. They said, please go away from us, because you are mightier than us. May the Lord make you mightier than your enemies. May the Lord make you mightier than the people that are against you in the name of Jesus. They said it. You are mightier than us. Go away. There's no way they can push him. Where are you pushing God to? When God is with him, you are pushing God. You push him away, you are pushing God. Where can you push God to? Instead, they will leave the place for him. Praise the Lord. And that's the reason why he was able to expand in that place. The Lord make him to expand in that place. He covered everywhere. Instead of him to leave the place, they left the place for him. See what he said. You know, he was digging well and they will cover it. He would dig, they would cover it, until they could not cover the well again. See verse 22. And he removed from thence and dig another well. And for that, they strove not. They didn't argue with him again. And he called the name of it Rehoboth. What is the meaning? He said, for now the Lord has made room for us. We shall be fruitful in the land. May the Lord make room for you. Wherever you are, may the Lord make room for you. You that is hearing me, may the Lord make room for you. Wherever you are, and the Lord will make you to be fruitful in that place. In Jesus' name. Because the Lord prosper him and they envy him. And they saw it. And nobody could drive him away. But instead, people were away from him. Because the Lord make room for him. And let him expand himself. And then spread his tentacles. And that one, what did he cause? He made him to be fruitful in the land. Where you are, you'll be fruitful. In Jesus' name. Hezekiah also. Hezekiah prospered in his days. Became because the Lord was with him. In 2 Kings chapter 18, the Bible says something here. 2 Kings chapter 18, verse 7. The Bible says here, verse 7. And the Lord was with him, that is Hezekiah, and he prospered whithersoever he went forth. And he rebelled against the king of Assyria and served him not, because you will not serve your enemy in Jesus' name. Amen. The moment you realize that God is with you, the presence of God is with you, you will not serve your enemy. May God open our eyes to know that God's presence is always with us in Jesus' name. God's presence attracts favor. That is grace. Joseph was favored before man and before God. He found grace in the sight of his master. In verse 39, in verse 4 of 39, the Bible says that he found grace before his master. May God to find grace before the people that are surrounding us in the name of Jesus. The place where you are walking, may God make you to find grace there. And to find favor in the sight of the people there in Jesus' name. When you don't find favor, that is the time that they will be looking for how to drive you away. But when you find favor, they want to try it, they can, nobody will be able to remove you. Anybody that touches you has touched problem. And Joseph found grace in his sight, and served him, and he made him overseer over his house and all that he had put his hands upon. Praise the Lord. Can you see? They made him overseer. What made him to be able to be made overseer? Because the grace of God, when the presence of God was with him, it attracted the favor of man and God. All that he put his hands upon prospered. He was dwelling in favor. The Lord said he was well favored. When you are well favored, you are dwelling in favor. You are surrounded with favor. You are eating in favor. May God make you to become one like that in Jesus' name. He was favored everywhere. Eating in favor. Surrounded by favor. Walking in favor. Everything favor. Do you see? Even when he was in prison, he was made the head of the prisoners. He was now controlling his inmates. He was not acting like a prisoner because the Lord favored him. Just come here, come and relax. The Lord allowed him to be there so that he can come there to relax. Praise the Lord. And that reason, when he got there, he was the one in charge of his inmates. And Isaac, the Lord favored him. And he was found faithful. You know, when the presence of the Lord is with you, you'll be found faithful. Isaac was favored before Abimelech and declared him untouchable. They say, nobody should touch him. Whosoever that touch him, the person must be a dead man. Praise the Lord. That is the favor of God. Favor of God will protect you. Favor of the Lord, the presence of the Lord will protect you, will make you to be favored. In chapter 26, verse 11, the Bible says, "And Abimelech charged all his people, say, he that touches this man or his wife shall surely be put to death." God will protect you when his presence is with you. You are untouchable. Even though they want to deceive, they will change their mind. He said, nobody, whosoever that put them to the person. must put to them to death. May we receive may we be attracted by the presence of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Can you understand what Moses was saying when he said, "Your presence must go with me. I want your presence to go with me." Nobody will be able to rule him out. Joseph ran away. The God's presence made Joseph to run away from what? God's presence made him to be favored. Now we talk about the presence of God. The presence of God commands holy living. When you have the presence of God, you will live a holy life. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The presence of the Lord commands holy living. That is the reason why the fear, when you, the presence of the Lord is to you, fear God. Why many people are not fearing God? Because the presence of God, they don't know whether God is with them or not. But the presence of God will make you to fear God. What is the beginning of wisdom? The Bible says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. When you fear God, you will have wisdom. When you fear God, it is the presence of God will make you to fear God. If the presence of the Lord is not with you, you cannot fear God. If the spirit of the Lord is not with you, you cannot fear God at all. You don't know. God's presence made Joseph to run away from pollution of sin. Say, how can I commit this great wickedness against my God? Can you see? Many people now, they are seeing immorality as something, as enjoyment. They see it as enjoyment. They see it as joy. They see it as something good. But because they lack the presence of God, the power, the presence of God is not with them. The spirit of God is not directing them. It's not ruling them. That is the reason why they see sin as seeing as something that is joyful. They see sin as something they can play with. They see sin as something they can eat. As if they are eating water and eating food and drink and as if they are drinking water. Because they lack the presence of God. But Joseph saw it. Ha! He ran away from the pollution of sin. See, how can I commit this great wickedness against my God? He ran away. And through this, he was in prison. None of that, the Lord was sending him to the place where he was going to become great. You know, when you do something, you are running away from sin. It's not that maybe you don't know what to do. See Daniel. Daniel said in Daniel chapter 1, verse 8. See that he fled. He said that I will not defile myself with the portion of the king's meat. He did not. Why? Because the presence of God with him. He was conscious of his God's presence. May we be conscious of God's presence in our lives in Jesus' name. Let us be conscious of God's presence. David spoke in Psalm chapter 1, verse 3. David was speaking here because David was conscious of his presence, of God's presence. And that is the reason why he wants everybody. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of scornful. But his delight is in the law, his law doth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Can you see? May God help us in Jesus' name. Whatever he does, prosper, because you are living in the Lord. You are separating yourself from evil of the day, from the people that are destructive, the people that are sinners. You separate yourself from them. God will be able to move with you, will be able to direct your life, be able to direct the affair of your life. But you are moving with evil people, corrupt people, or evil friends. The Lord will not be able to direct you. He will not be able to speak to you because you're not here. You move, separate yourself from those people that can contaminate you, from those people that can defy you, from those people that do not make you to move forward, so that God will not be able to speak to you. Separate yourself from them. Don't move along with them. The people that are living a different lifestyle, that's ungodly, don't move with them. Separate yourself so that the Lord can bless you. You move with them, the blessing of God may not stand your life. The blessing of God will not stand your life. That is the reason why you need to live a holy life. Keep yourself holy and live your life for God. God's presence make us fulfill divine destiny and also guide the divine safety. It was the presence of the Lord that was with Joseph that made Joseph now to be remembered. When was he placed? I was taken to the place of honor where God wanted me to land. You know, that is what God can do. If he has not feared the law and ran away from that woman, he wouldn't have been praising. From prison to palace, the Lord will take you to a palace in the name of Jesus. The Lord will take you from the palace, but you need to run away from sin. Run away from those things that will tag you. Run away from those things that make God's word not to be free in your life. When you make the miracle of God not to work out in your life, run away from those things. If Joseph had not run away, he would have used the things of this world, something for 5 minutes enjoyment, to substitute divine inheritance. Forever, he missed it. That will not miss it in Jesus' name. Joseph, he relaxed with the law. I followed the law and did not allow the enemy to overtake him. He overtake the schemes of the enemy because the presence of God was with him. From prison, even when man has forgotten him, the Lord brought something that will remember him, that made him to be remembered. And make Pharaoh to have a dream. The Bible says the dream was from the Lord. The dream was where? From the Lord. That dream was not an ordinary dream. And nobody among the astrologers, among his wise men, could interpret it. They have to send for Joseph because the Lord was working with Joseph. The Lord remember him. May the Lord remember you. Wherever you are that you think they have been forgotten, and people thought that you have forgotten, and your destiny has been forgotten, your destiny is buried, the Lord will remember you. And the Lord will take you out of your obscurity in Jesus' name. The Lord took him out because he remembered him. The Lord remembered him and brought him out. You know, the person that he told, the chief butler, he told him, I said, please remember me when it is due for you. The Bible says he did not remember him until after 2 years, when the dream of a king came up. That was the time he was able to remember that there was somebody like Joseph. May the Lord set up strategies that will make you to be remembered in life. Even when people say they cannot remember you, when people have written your case off, when people have said that there is nothing that can happen in your life, there is no way you can achieve anything in life, there is no way you can amount to somebody in life, the Lord will remember you in the name of Jesus. I say the Lord will remember you. The Bible says that the Lord, the presence of the Lord, was with Joshua. And the Lord remembered Joshua and made him great. And his fame became great in the land of Israel. The Lord will make you so like that in Jesus' name. Shall we pray?